God. Oh, invite Brother Sasu to come and pray for the opening prayer and offering.
Shall we pray? Our dear Heavenly Father, we thank you this evening for your loving kindness, for your goodness, for your shield, for your protection, for all that you have done for us, O Lord, throughout the whole day. We left here Sunday. Till now, Lord, thy hands upon us. If it is not you, O Lord, we cannot make it this night. But because thy grace, O Lord, abide with us, always with us, that has brought us here tonight, O Lord. It is not something that we know how to do, or it's not because, Lord, we think we're so special, but, Lord, you have made us special. And tonight, if we are here, Lord, we want to give all unto you. Lord, tonight we come surrounding from head to toe, knowing that, Lord, in thee, O God, there is solution to every trouble. No matter how big the problem is, you always have solution to it. So if we are here tonight, Lord, we want to lay in thy bosom tonight. May you come, O God, and take a hold of us. We lay every trouble, every burden, O God, before you. Diamond servant, O God, that will stand behind the pulpit. Lord, he has no words, O Lord, to tell your children if you do not visit him, if you do not tell him something. That is why this hour, O God, we pray, putting him aside, O Father, that through that vessel, O Father, something that you know that we need this hour, O God, will come out. And we that are the listener also, Lord, may you give us that ears. May you give us that understanding. Circumcise us this hour, O Father, that we can, Lord, accept thy word. Those on the web, O Father, those in line, those, O Lord, those are in their various home, I pray, committing them all into thy hands this hour, O Lord. It's what you put in is what you get out. Lord Jesus, may you have mercy on them. Lord, may you be with them. May they have that revelation, O God, knowing that wherever they are, the Lord God is there. Come bless us this hour, because blessings come from thee. I know this hour, Lord, you are in our midst, because your promise said so. Lord Jesus, you are not a man, O God, that will promise and will not do. What promise you have, you always say, O Lord Jesus, you fulfill it. Because of that, Lord, we all believe you are here with us. Wherever two or three are gathered in thy name, you are there. Lord Jesus, here we are this evening. We are more than that number. More, over more than that number. So I believe, Lord, you are here this hour. Lord, come bless us. Pray for the tithes. Pray for the offering. Pray for everyone this hour, O Lord. You know our burden. You know what we need this hour, O Lord Jesus. Because you that can read our inside, know all the trouble that is in there and need know what we need. Father, we lay everything before you this evening. Lord Jesus, indeed there is solution. We pray for the tithes also and the offering. May you bless us. Those that do not have job, that are looking for job, Father, may you make a way for each of everyone tonight. Those, O Lord, that are in the Holy Ghost, may you make a way for us all. The song leader, I commit him in thy hands. The musicians, I bring them before you. The entire audience, the ones that are here, the ones that are out there, commit them all into thy hands. Bless us tonight. Give you glory and the honor. In Jesus Christ's name, we pray with thanksgiving. Amen.
Thank you, Brother Sasu. Are you all happy? Just go ahead and shake your neighbor's hand and express your joy. And tonight is a prayer service. And please, for those who are online, send us our request. You know, while respecting the privacy, we are not going to call out the names, right? Let's sing. Let's talk about Jesus in F. Let's talk about Jesus, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, supreme through all eternity. The great I am, the way, the truth, the life, the door. Let's talk about Jesus more and more. One more time. Let's talk about
we'll gather.
sister-in-law Grace, she said she was actually joking with me. She was actually trying to imitate how I dance, right? And I told her, when I'm leading song, I enjoy myself. You know, that's, you know, it's as if I was in my car just singing by myself. So, you know, you either sing with me or I sing by myself, right? All right, let's sing Through It All to invite the preacher.
God, through it all.
the last time.
Heavenly Father, tonight, Lord, regardless of our situation, we want to praise your holy name, dear Lord. David said, I'll bless the Lord at all times.
David a dit, je vais bénir l'Éternel en tout moment.
In the good and the bad and the beautiful and the ugly, Lord, we want to thank you tonight.
Dans le bon, dans le mauvais, dans le la beauté ou dans la laideur, nous voulons te remercier cette soir.
It could have been worse by your grace and your mercy as brothers thus far.
Ça pouvait être pire, mais c'est ta grâce qui nous a ramenés jusqu'en ce lieu.
And we have no doubt grace will lead us on to an expected end.
Et nous n'avons pas de doute que ta grâce va nous ramener jusqu'à la fin.
Tonight, Lord, we've gathered as your children, dear Lord, to commune with you, Lord, concerning our needs.
Ce soir, Père, nous nous rassemblons comme tes enfants pour pouvoir communier autour de ta parole afin que tu puisses répondre à nos besoins.
Except you come, Lord, our meeting will be in vain.
Si tu ne venais pas, notre service sera en vain.
But thanks be unto your holy name that you are faithful, he who has promised that where two or three are gathered, there I'll be in their midst.
Mais merci à Dieu parce que toi tu es fidèle, toi qui as promis que là où deux ou trois sont réunis, je serai au milieu d'eux.
And tonight we already feel your presence, dear Lord.
Et ce soir nous sentons déjà ta présence, Père Céleste.
Therefore we cry and let an angel of mercy pass by tonight.
Ainsi nous demandons que ton ange de miséricorde passe ce soir.
And meet us all at the point of our need, the young and the old, Heavenly Father.
Et puisse répondre à nos besoins, le jeune comme le vieux.
Grant us the strength to pray according to the utterance that will be given to us by the Holy Ghost.
Donne-nous la grâce pour pouvoir prier conformément à l'envie que ton Saint-Esprit va nous donner.
Let it not be vain babblings, dear Lord.
Que ça ne soit pas de paroles vaines.
Have thine own way in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we pray.
Et ta propre volonté au nom de notre Seigneur Jésus Christ, nous avons prié.
Amen.
Amen.
Oh, it's good to be in His presence. Amen.
Il est beau d'être dans sa présence.
I bring you greetings in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Je vous ramène les salutations au nom de notre Seigneur Jésus Christ.
It's always good to be back home.
C'est toujours joyeux d'être dans la maison, de rentrer à la maison.
To fellowship with brethren of like precious faith. Amen.
Pour communier avec le frère qui ont une foi semblable.
So tonight we are going to pray.
Donc ce soir nous allons prier.
How many love to pray?
Combien aiment prier?
I love to pray. Amen.
J'aime prier.
Because there's power in prayer.
Parce qu'il y a la puissance dans la prière.
I've driven for long hours today. The body is tired, but I love to pray. Amen.
Je conduis pendant longtemps et je suis fatigué, mais j'aime prier.
If you promise me tonight that we're going to stay here all night and all that we're going to do is to pray, I will be willing to stay.
Si vous me disiez que nous allons rester ici pendant toute la nuit et c'est que tout ce que nous allons faire,
because
c'est de
there's
prier,
power in prayer. Amen.
Parce qu'il y a la puissance dans la prière.
But tonight I'm not going to keep you all night. Amen.
Mais ce soir je ne veux pas vous garder ici pendant toute
whether
la nuit.
Whether 5 or 10 minutes, we're still going to pray. Amen.
Que ce soit 5 ou 10 minutes, nous allons prier.
So let's turn our Bibles to 1 Peter 4, 12 to 19.
Nous allons prendre notre Bible dans 1 Pierre.
1 Peter 4.
1 Pierre 4.
12 to 19.
12 à 19.
The last time I gave Brother Pichu a hard time, so today I'm going to be a good man.
Okay? La fois passée, j'ai donné à Frère Pichu des difficultés
aujourd'hui. I've told him if he sees me misbehaving with the interpretation, he should tap me.
So je lui ai dit s'il me voyait en train de
comporter
mal,
also help me out here. Amen. Yeah. So 1 Peter 4, I'll read verse by verse so that he also reads.
Je vais lire verset par verset.
So verse 12. Beloved, think it not strange concerning the fiery trial which is to try you, as though some strange thing happened unto you.
Bien-aimés, ne soyez pas surpris comme d'une chose étrange qui vous arrive de la fournaise qui est au milieu de vous pour vous éprouver.
But rejoice, inasmuch as ye are partakers of Christ's sufferings, that when his glory shall be revealed, ye may be glad also with exceeding joy.
Réjouissez-vous au contraire de la part que vous avez aux souffrances de Christ, afin que vous soyez aussi dans la joie et dans l'allégresse lorsque sa gloire apparaîtra.
If ye be reproached for the name of Christ, happy are ye. Hallelujah. For the spirit of glory and of God rested upon you. On their part he is evil spoken of, but on your part he is glorified.
Si vous êtes outragé pour le nom de Christ, vous êtes heureux parce que l'Esprit de gloire, l'Esprit de Dieu repose sur vous.
But let none of you suffer as a murderer, or as a thief, or as an evildoer, or as a busybody in other men's matters.
Que nul de vous, en effet, ne souffre comme meurtrier, ou voleur, ou malfaiteur, ou comme s'ingérant dans les affaires d'autrui.
Yet if any man suffer as a Christian, let him not be ashamed, but let him glorify God on this behalf. Amen.
Mais si quelqu'un souffre comme chrétien, qu'il n'en ait point honte et que plutôt il glorifie Dieu à cause de ce nom.
For the time is come that judgment must begin at the house of God. And if it first begin at us, what shall the end be of them that obey not the gospel of God?
Car c'est le moment où le jugement va commencer par la maison de Dieu. Or, si c'est par nous qu'il commence, quelle sera la fin de ceux qui n'obéissent pas à l'évangile de Dieu?
And if the righteous scarcely be saved, where shall the ungodly and the sinner appear?
Et si le juste se sauve avec peine, que deviendront l'impie et le pécheur?
Wherefore let them that suffer according to the will of God commit the keeping of their souls to him in well doing as unto a faithful creator.
Ainsi que ceux qui souffrent selon la volonté de Dieu remettent leurs âmes au fidèle Créateur en faisant ce qui est bien.
May the Lord add a blessing to the reading of His word. Amen.
Que Dieu ajoute la bénédiction à la lecture de sa parole.
Kindly be seated.
Vous pouvez vous asseoir gentiment.
So tonight is a prayer meeting, so I don't intend taking long.
Donc ce soir c'est la réunion de prière. Je n'ai pas l'intention de prendre plus de temps.
So I was just thinking how short can be, and I said okay. The last time I visited, we started a topic and I didn't do justice to it. So I want to take a little block from that, then we use as a base to pray tonight. Amen.
Donc je me demandais combien courte la prédication sera, mais la fois passée quand j'étais venu, j'avais commencé une prédication, mais je n'avais pas fait justice à cela. Mais aujourd'hui, je veux prendre juste un bloc et nous allons la traiter.
So it's been a while. So the last time we talked about growing pains of His grace.
Donc la fois passée nous avions parlé de la douleur qui croît de sa grâce.
And we saw we just a reminder, we saw that salvation has birth as in time here. Let's say a point A. I used a pen the last time, so I'm using it again.
Et comme nous avions dit le salut, nous allons utiliser un stylo comme notre représentation, et ici au point A.
And we are marching forward to a glorious end, which is point B.
Et nous sommes en train de marcher à une gloire, une fin glorieuse qui est le point B.
But this path is what we labeled the last time as growing pains of His grace.
Mais ce chemin, c'est ce que nous avions appelé la douleur croissante de sa grâce.
Do we all remember now?
Est-ce que nous nous rappelons de ça?
Yeah, so we saw that the trials and the temptations, all that we go through is to produce certain traits in us in order to bring us to the stature of a perfect man.
Donc nous avions vu que les épreuves, le tourment que nous traversons, c'est juste pour nous ramener à la stature d'un homme parfait.
And we saw three traits, we touched on actually two, I didn't get to the third. That is supposed to produce patience, it's supposed to produce experience, and the last one was hope in Christ Jesus.
Alors, nous avions vu trois, je n'ai pas parlé de trois, mais j'ai parlé de deux, c'était la patience
et hope.
The second one.
Patience, experience, and hope.
La patience, l'expérience et le dernier c'était l'espérance.
So I'm just going to read a quote to refresh your mind, and we go on, okay?
Donc je vais lire juste une citation pour.
So we read this quote the last time. It says, "You say, but Brother Branham, what about my mother and my dad? What about my people? What about my denomination?"
Alors tu dis, frère Branham, quand serait-il de ma mère? Quand serait-il de mon père? De mon peuple? Quand serait-il de ma dénomination?
What would they do?
Que feront-ils?
They will cast me out.
Ils vont me chasser.
Is it? If you can't look ahead, look up.
Si tu ne peux pas regarder devant, alors regarde en haut.
Don't try to look ahead anyhow. Put your hand in His. Hallelujah.
N'essaye pas de regarder devant. Mets juste ton main dans sa main.
Let Him lead you.
Qu'il te conduise.
Look up.
Regarde
Don't look ahead.
Ne regarde pas devant.
You say why? Others make fun of me about having long hair and me taking off shorts and about me leaving the church, huh?
Vous dites non, mais pourquoi les gens se moquent de moi de porter de longs cheveux, porter de longues jupes ou tout ça?
Suffering for His word, see. Suffering for His name's sake is growing pains of His grace. Yeah.
Souffrir pour son nom, c'est une peine croissante de sa grâce.
Suffering for His word, see, is growing pains of His grace. Yes, sir.
Souffrir pour à cause de sa parole, c'est une souffrance qui grandit pour sa grâce.
Just remember, it's the grace of God has been given to you, oh
Juste,
my.
Rappelez-vous que c'est la grâce de Dieu qui vous a été accordée, oh mon Dieu.
So Brother Branham used the character of Paul. He says, like Paul said, hallelujah, he had an infirmity, something was bothering him.
Et Frère Branham utilise un exemple comme Paul, il dit, hallelujah, il avait une infirmité, quelque chose qui le dérangeait.
The devil would buffer him blow after blow.
Le diable lui donnait des coups de poing un après l'autre.
And he consulted the Lord three times to take it away from him, said, I don't want this, Lord, take it away from me.
Et il a consulté le Seigneur trois fois, il a demandé à Dieu, je ne veux pas cette histoire, écarte cela de moi.
And then one night the Lord spoke to him, said, Saul or Paul, my grace is sufficient for you. Hallelujah.
Alors un jour, Dieu lui a parlé, il a dit, Saul ou Paul, ma grâce était suffit.
He said, "Then I will glory in my infirmity."
Alors il a dit, j'aurai la gloire dans mon infirmité.
I will glory in it.
Je vais me glorifier en cela.
So tonight we all go the same thing. We are going through trials and temptation, but because it's the grace of God given to us, we will glory in our infirmity. Hallelujah.
Et ce soir, comme nous traversons des difficultés, mais nous, comme nous sommes, nous allons nous glorifier dans sa gloire.
You are the healer.
Tu es le guérisseur.
I've seen you heal the sick, raise the dead, cast out devils, open the eyes of the blind.
J'étais vu guérir les malades et ressusciter les morts et chasser les démons, ouvrir les yeux des aveugles.
But Paul says, but if I have consulted you and you tell me it's your grace, you tell me it's your grace is sufficient, then this devil that bothers me is growing pains of your grace.
Alors Paul dit, si je t'ai consulté et tu me dis que ta grâce me suffit, donc ce démon qui est en train de me déranger est une douleur croissante de ta grâce.
Then I will glory in my infirmity.
Alors je vais me glorifier dans mon infirmité.
So that was just a background to what we're going to talk about tonight.
Ça c'était juste un rappel de ce, un aperçu de ce que nous allons parler aujourd'hui.
That we are going through a phase where we are being encompassed with growing pains of His grace.
Que nous sommes en train de traverser une étape où nous sommes dérangés par la douleur croissante de sa grâce.
But I'm going to look at the 1 Peter 4:19. He says, "Wherefore let them that suffer according to the will of God commit the keeping of their souls to Him in well." Do it.
Alors, je vais regarder
verse 19, 4:19. Yes. As unto a faithful creator.
Ainsi que ceux qui souffrent selon la volonté de Dieu remettent leurs âmes au fidèle créateur en faisant ce qui est bien.
So that in all these things you ought to still regard God as a faithful God.
Donc dans toutes ces choses tu dois toujours continuer à regarder Dieu comme un Dieu fidèle.
So we'll go to 2 Timothy 2:7-14 and see how Paul describes it to Timothy.
Alors, nous allons voir dans 2 Timothée
2:7-14,
et nous allons voir comment Paul décrit ça à Timothée.
Consider what I say, and the Lord give thee understanding in all things. Remember that Jesus Christ of the seed of David was raised from the dead according to my gospel, wherein I suffer trouble as an evildoer, even unto bonds, but the word of God is not bound. Afraid 7-9.
Continue. Yeah, continue.
Okay. Therefore, I endure all things for the elect's sakes, that they may also obtain salvation, which is in Christ Jesus with eternal glory. It is a faithful saying, for if we be dead with him, we shall also live with him. Amen. If we suffer, we shall also reign with him. If Amen. We deny him, he also will deny us. If we believe not, yet he abideth faithful, he cannot deny himself.
Amen.
Comprends ce que je dis, car le Seigneur te donnera l'intelligence en toutes choses. Souviens-toi que Jésus-Christ, issu de la postérité de David, est suscité des morts selon mon évangile, pour lequel je souffre jusqu'à être lié comme un malfaiteur. Mais la parole de Dieu n'est pas liée. C'est pourquoi je supporte tout à cause des élus, afin qu'eux aussi obtiennent le salut en Jésus, qui est en Jésus-Christ avec la gloire éternelle. Cette parole est certaine. Si nous sommes morts avec lui, nous vivrons aussi avec lui.
So the verse 13 is what I'm looking at tonight. If we believe not, yet he abideth faithful, he cannot deny himself. Verse 13.
All right, verset 12. Si nous sommes infidèles, il demeure fidèle car il ne peut se renier lui-même.
So what he's trying to tell us that in all things we ought to regard God as faithful. Hallelujah.
Ce qu'il essaye de nous dire, c'est que dans toutes choses, nous devons regarder Dieu comme étant fidèle.
So we'll turn now to 1 Corinthians 10, 12-13.
Donc, 1 Corinthiens 10, 1 à 13.
We're now starting the sermon. That one was a background, a reminder.
Donc, nous sommes juste en train de commencer notre sermon. Ça, c'est so, juste un rappel.
1 Corinthiens 10, 12-13. Wherefore, let him that thinketh he standeth take heed, lest he fall. There had no temptation taken you, but such as common to man. But God is faithful. Hallelujah. Who will not suffer you to be tempted above that ye are able, but will with the temptation also make a way to escape that ye may be able to bear it. Mm-hmm. You say amen.
Dites amen.
Did you hear what I said?
Est-ce que vous avez entendu ce que je dis?
Let me read it again.
Je vais lire ça une fois de plus.
Where are your Bibles?
Où sont vos Bibles?
Look at your Bibles. I'm reading the 13th verse again.
Je vais lire le 13e verset.
There had no temptation taking you, but such is common to man. But God is. Hey, people are sleeping now.
Oh, les gens sont en train de dormir.
But God is. Who will not suffer you to be tempted above that ye are able, but will with the temptation also make a way to escape that ye may be able to bear. This should bring smiles to us. Hallelujah.
Ça doit nous faire sourire. Ainsi donc, que celui qui croit être debout prenne garde de tomber. Aucune tentation ne vous est survenue qui n'ait été humaine, et Dieu qui est fidèle ne permettra pas que vous soyez tentés au-delà de vos forces. Mais avec la tentation, il préparera aussi le moyen d'en sortir afin que vous puissiez la supporter.
So, brethren, God is faithful.
Alors, bien-aimé, Dieu est fidèle.
He who has promised that he will make a way of escape for us is a faithful one.
Lui qui a promis qu'il va donner une voie pour la sortie, il est le plus fidèle.
And once he said it, if you believe, whether you believe or not, he will bring it to pass.
Une fois qu'il est dit, que vous le croyez ou pas, il va l'accomplir.
But the secret is that if you want it to be beneficial to you, you ought to believe.
Mais le secret est que si vous voulez que vous puissiez être bénéficiaire de cela, vous devez croire.
His word will never fail.
Sa volonté ne va jamais faillir.
But for it to be beneficiary to you in time, you ought to believe and that word fulfilled in your life.
Alors pour que vous puissiez bénéficier de cela, vous devez croire, alors cela va s'accomplir au moment opportun pour
and
vous.
I believe tonight that we as a body of believers believe that our God is faithful.
Et je crois ce soir que nous en tant que corps de croyants, nous croyons que notre Dieu est fidèle.
And he will make a way of escape for
et
us.
Il va frayer une voie de sortie pour nous.
So let me get some beginning quotes here. What Brother Branham said about God being faithful. We'll wrap up soon. Don't worry. I'll
je vais
take
prendre
long time.
Quelques citations pour voir ce que Frère Branham a dit à propos de Dieu.
Brother Branham said in a message, God's Preparation 54 says, there are sick people sitting right here now that will go out of here tonight to be well.
Alors, Frère Branham dit ici, alors les malades qui sont assis ici vont sortir d'ici et ils seront en bonne santé.
I didn't hear amen.
Oh, je n'ai pas entendu un amen.
We are in church, oh.
Nous sommes à l'église.
We are not in a conference
nous
where
nous
one person speaks.
Nous sommes dans une conférence où juste une seule personne parle.
Are you sleeping?
Est-ce que vous dormez?
Everybody rise, everybody
okay,
rise.
OK, vous tous, tenez-vous debout, tenez-vous debout.
Brother Kingsley, you want to give us some drill so to shake the people up?
Frère Kingsley, est-ce que tu veux nous donner quelque
everybody
chose?
Everybody say amen.
Tout le monde dit amen.
I drove about 8 hours to get here. If I'm shouting, you should be able to shout too.
J'ai conduit pendant 8 heures. Si je suis en train de crier, vous devez tous crier.
God bless you. I'm greeting you. Sit down.
Que Dieu vous bénisse. Vous pouvez vous asseoir.
There's no doubt dying people sitting right here tonight will go out here with life to live again.
Il n'y a aucun doute que les gens qui sont mourants, qui sont ici, vont sortir d'ici avec la vie une fois de plus.
Brother Branham said, praise God.
Frère Branham dit, béni soit le Seigneur.
Why? Why will it be so?
Pourquoi il sera ainsi?
The same Holy Spirit that led Simeon leads or leads us tonight.
Le même Saint-Esprit qui a conduit Simeon est en train de nous conduire ce soir.
Don't be scared to drink.
N'ayez pas peur de boire.
Walk right up freely with a lot of boldness.
Alors, marchez tout simplement dans la liberté avec beaucoup d'audace.
Tonight we are going to go to pray. Don't pray like you are timid. You don't know who you are talking to. The one you are speaking to is a faithful God. And believe that once you put your request before him, he will answer.
Alors, ce soir nous allons prier. Ne soyez pas timide. Priez, sachant que c'est lui à qui vous allez adresser votre prière. Il est plus que fidèle pour répondre.
We come boldly to the throne of God for God. God is faithful. Hallelujah.
Nous venons avec courage au trône de Dieu parce que Dieu est fidèle.
For God is faithful who has promised us, don't be scared.
Que Dieu est celui qui est fidèle, c'est celui qui nous a promis de ne pas
no
avoir peur.
No matter the situation, whether you are home, whether you are here, don't be scared.
Qu'importe la situation, que vous soyez à la maison ou que vous soyez ici, you know, n'ayez pas peur.
Brother Brown said the greatest curse on the church is fear.
Right. Frère Branham dit que la plus grande preuve sur l'église c'est la peur.
Fear that God will not keep his word.
La crainte que Dieu ne va pas garder sa parole.
But brethren, we have a Bible full of testimonies that our God, he is faithful.
Alors, frères, nous avons la Bible qui est pleine de témoignages que notre Dieu est fidèle.
We have 1,100 and over messages that tells us that our God is faithful.
Nous avons plus de 1,100 messages qui nous montrent que notre Dieu est fidèle.
So why should you be scared?
Alors, pourquoi auriez-vous peur?
Reach up and get it. It's yours.
Alors, étendez votre main et recevez cela, ça vous appartient.
He's led you right up to the fountain.
Il vous a conduit jusqu'à la fontaine.
If you are thirsty, drink.
Si vous avez soif, buvez.
You know the saddest thing to ever witness is to walk a horse or anybody to the, even human beings. Let's say you are in a desert and you are thirsty and you get to a river and you can't drink.
Vous savez, la chose la plus triste, c'est que vous, quand vous êtes par exemple avec votre cheval dans un désert et vous arrivez là où il y a de l'eau, vous ne pouvez pas boire.
I'm not too grown, but growing up, I had a proverb in our home that he said, you know, it's very sad to see a drowning man crying out that he's thirsty. A man that is drowning and shouting that he's thirsty.
Je ne suis pas vieux, mais il y a un proverbe qui dit chez nous que non, il est plus triste de voir quelqu'un qui est en train de se noyer et qui dit qu'il a soif.
That's very sad.
C'est vraiment triste.
And we are laughing. It's the same thing with Christians, believers.
C'est la même chose avec les chrétiens aujourd'hui.
We are in a pool of blessings of the living God.
Nous sommes dans la piscine des bénédictions.
But we are failing to judge him faithful, he who has promised. Hence, we are not experiencing the blessings.
Mais nous craignons d'expérimenter celui qui a promis qu'il est fidèle.
So tonight, I am reminding you, that's the title of my sermon, judging him faithful, he who has promised. Hallelujah.
Maintenant, le titre de ma prédication, c'est le jugeant, lui, fidèle qui a donné la promesse.
Brother Branham said, just drink abundance, drink till you can't drink no more.
Frère Branham dit, juste buvez abondamment jusqu'au point où vous ne pouvez plus boire.
Drink till you get so drunk on the salvation of God, you will not listen to critics, nor listen to your feelings or any symptoms.
Buvez jusqu'au point où vous serez tellement saoulé que vous ne pouvez plus entendre des critiques au salut, des critiques de gens qui ne peuvent qui parlent de leurs émotions et ou de leurs symptômes.
You know, about a couple of weeks ago, God taught me a lesson.
Vous savez, il y a quelques semaines, Dieu m'a enseigné une leçon.
Brethren, if you encounter any problem and you fail to keep your eyes on the promises of God, you always linger in defeat.
Vous savez, frère, quand vous vous retrouvez devant une preuve et vous ne pouvez pas vous reposer dans la promesse de Dieu, vous allez toujours être dans l'échec.
I had a situation that was impossible.
J'avais une situation qui était impossible.
By current of my status in the country.
Concernant mon statut dans le pays.
And I was there, I was thinking, Lord, how do I go about this?
J'étais là et je me demandais, Seigneur, qu'est-ce que je ferais?
And it dawned on me, it's because you fail to take a leap of faith.
Ça m'est venu à l'esprit que c'est parce que tu as manqué de prendre ça.
I am standing here reading, it's very easy to read.
Vous savez, comme je lis ici, c'est facile de lire.
But when it comes to the action of plunging in faith, brethren, it takes only the true believer.
Mais frère, quand ça arrive au point où vous devez appliquer la foi, ça, c'est seulement aux croyants.
So I took that leap of faith, and lo and behold, within minutes, God made a way.
Alors j'ai pris ce pas de foi. Alors dans quelques minutes, Dieu avait pourvu un chemin.
Brethren, our God is faithful. That's all I'm trying to tell you tonight.
Notre Dieu est fidèle. C'est ce que j'essaie de vous dire ce soir.
So Brother Branham said, you look to Calvary and say, God, I want to hear the roars of Calvary. That's all I want to hear. And what did he say at Calvary? It is finished.
Alors, vous regardez au calvaire et dites tout simplement, Seigneur, je veux entendre le murmure du calvaire. Qu'est-ce qu'il a dit au calvaire? Tout est accompli.
Let me just read a quote.
Je vais juste lire une citation.
It's sweet. I love reading the Bible and I love listening to the message.
J'aime lire la Bible et j'aime écouter le message.
You know, it's an individual affair.
Vous savez, c'est une chose individuelle.
You don't depend on anybody. Do any, you know, it should mean to you as it's a matter of death and life.
Donc, vous savez, ça doit être pour vous comme une affaire de vie et de mort.
I don't read the Bible or listen to the course because I'm coming to preach. No,
je ne lis pas la Bible ou écoute le message parce que je viens prêcher.
I remember when Brother Marion told me that I should do Sunday school. I said, no, do it because I want to come, sit down, listen, and do a personal salvation work. It's not a matter of showmanship.
Yeah. Je me rappelle quand frère Marion m'avait demandé d'enseigner l'école de dimanche, je lui avais dit non, fais-le, parce que moi je vais venir m'asseoir et écouter et travailler sur mon salut. Je ne veux pas venir faire une démonstration.
So I told him, if I sit down 2 years, 3 years, I don't come to the pop, I don't mind.
Je lui ai dit, si je m'asseyais 2 ans, 3 ans sans venir à la chaire, ça ne me dérange pas.
Because it is not by virtue of preaching that you go to heaven. No.
Parce que ce n'est pas parce que tu prêches que tu iras au ciel.
Anyway, let me leave that. Let me
non,
go.
Je vais laisser ça.
So one more quote, then we'll get into a little, then we'll pray. Amen.
Une petite citation et nous allons entrer dans la prière.
Brother Branham said, let's see back in the beginning when God was fixing to bring forth his son. Why? The first thing he appeared was to vindicate of his coming was Zacharias, an old priest, fine character, him and his wife.
Alors, voyons, là au commencement, ce que Dieu était en train de faire pour amener son fils. Qu'est-ce qu'il a fait? La première chose, c'était il est apparu pour confirmer cela à sa venue à Zacharie, un vieux prêtre qui avait un bon caractère, lui et sa femme.
And they've been married for many years, growing old in age.
Ils étaient mariés depuis très longtemps, ils vieillissaient en âge.
They prayed earnestly for children.
Ils ont prié tellement pour un enfant.
God seemed not to answer their prayer.
C'est comme si Dieu ne répondait pas à leur prière.
But they were serving the Lord a devout life.
Et mais ils étaient en train de servir à Dieu, avec une vie dédiée.
Now that's where many people make an error.
C'est là où beaucoup de gens commettent l'erreur.
They pray for things, and because God don't give it to them in a few minutes, they think they are not going to get it.
Mais ils demandent quelque chose, mais parce que Dieu ne leur le donne pas au même moment, ils disent que Dieu a oublié.
See, if you ask for anything, don't waver.
Alors voyez, si vous demandez pour quelque chose, il faut pas être vacillant.
Believe you receive it, you shall have it.
Croyez que vous le recevrez et vous allez le recevoir.
Live right.
Vivez correctement.
Do right.
Agissez correctement.
And believe you are going to get it, and God is faithful who has promised. Hallelujah.
Alors croyez que vous allez le recevoir. Alors Dieu qui est fidèle va vous l'accorder.
One more quote. Then we'll
une autre citation avant que.
Brother Branham said, "Remember, listen, hear ye to it."
Alors, frère Branham dit, rappelez-vous, écoutez-le.
Believe it, unless you come through believing right now, it's settled forever.
Croyez-le ou soit vous le croyez ou résolvez cela une fois pour toutes.
If you don't come believing, don't come. It will only make you worse. That's
si vous ne croyez pas, ne venez pas parce que ça va juste vous rendre pire.
It will hinder your faith.
Ça va arrêter votre foi.
But if you believe that you are in the presence of Jesus Christ and not we, his servants.
Alors si tu crois que tu es dans la présence de Jésus-Christ, mais non seulement de son serviteur.
I'm sure the young folks, they think we are in Brother Marion's house. We are not in Brother Marion's house.
Je suis sûr que les petits enfants croient que nous sommes dans la maison de frère Marion.
Thursday between 7 to 9 or 9:30, we are in the presence of the living God.
Jeudi entre 7h et 21h, nous sommes dans la présence de Dieu.
And that's how you ought to see it. Even if you are living in this house, that's how you ought to see it.
C'est de cette façon que vous devez voir ça, même si vous vivez dans cette maison.
I heard my uncle and grandpa Martin complaining. Oh.
J'ai entendu mon oncle et mon grand-père Martin se plaindre.
That some young folks are la 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 la.
Il y a certains jeunes qui sont la 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 la.
Who are those? If you know you are the one that they were referring to, raise up your hand. They will see you on the camera.
Si tu sais que tu es celui dont on parlait.
Because I heard grandpa say it. The last Sunday I heard it too.
Et dimanche passé j'ai entendu ça aussi.
Let us change, okay?
Nous devons changer.
If I hear it again when I come back, I'll call you to come and explain why you were doing so.
Si j'entends encore une fois de plus, et la prochaine fois que je viendrai, je vais t'appeler pour venir expliquer.
God bless you.
Que Dieu vous bénisse. Amen.
I said God bless you now.
J'ai dit que Dieu vous bénisse.
Amen.
Amen.
Brother Branham said, and we are only carrying out witnesses as we lay hands on you. You know, Brother Branham, even if you have perfect faith, you won't come in the prayer line.
Frère Branham dit, même si vous avez la foi de la prière,
and
vous n'allez pas venir.
That's what we are building up to. You don't have to. It's good to lay hands and that. But because we are pressing on to that rapturing faith, you ought to believe that God's word is so, regardless.
Alors, mais c'est bien d'imposer les mains sur les gens. But nous sommes en train de travailler pour cette foi.
If you want the church elders to lay hands, they will lay hands anyway.
Si tu veux que les anciens imposent les mains sur toi, ils vont imposer les mains sur
and
toi.
And when we lay hands on you, believe it and go out there rejoicing, saying thank you, Lord.
Quand nous imposons nos mains sur toi, alors tu dois le croire. Et quand tu sors, tu dois continuer à croire que Dieu qui est fidèle l'a fait.
It's all settled.
C'est résolu.
So after the service, whatever need you put before the Lord, go rejoicing that it is settled.
Alors après le service, qu'importe le besoin que tu auras amené, sors d'ici croyant que c'est résolu.
No matter how long you've prayed for, go believing that it is so.
Qu'importe combien de temps tu as prié pour cela, vas-y et crois que c'est résolu.
Brother Branham said, don't you never change your mind.
Frère Branham dit, ne change jamais ta pensée.
The moment you change your mind, you are breaking the rocks, brother.
Une fois que vous changez votre pensée, vous.
Now remember, let me quote this again. Listen close, Brother Branham said.
Maintenant, je vais citer encore une fois de plus. Écoutez attentivement.
Your mind is your jury on this case.
Votre pensée est votre jury dans ce cas.
Whatever need you have, your mind is the jury.
Qu'importe le besoin dont vous avez, votre pensée est votre jury dans ces cas.
And your actions from here out will pronounce what your judgment is.
Et vos actions à partir d'ici vont prononcer ce que votre jugement sera.
You come in here, you say, well, I don't know anybody. Some people even come to prayer service unprepared. Anyhow, we are going for prayer meeting. You don't pray nothing. You expect God to meet you. God deal with business people, who.
Certaines personnes viennent
people à l'église. Who mean business.
Certaines personnes viennent à l'église, ils ne sont même pas préparés, ils n'ont même pas prié, ils viennent juste comme ça. Dieu ne va pas te rencontrer comme ça parce que Dieu rencontre les gens qui sont dans ses affaires.
You come in and you say, well, I don't know. You see, well, you see where you judge him. He's on trial to each one of you. He is here in your presence. His word is here. Hallelujah.
Vous venez ici et vous dites, oh, non, je vais juste, je ne sais pas ou je ne vois pas. Mais vous le jugez comme ça parce qu'il est au procès pour chacun d'entre nous. Il est ici. Nous sommes dans sa présence.
He vindicates his word.
Il confirme sa parole.
You are here. He is on trial to you, not on trial on me. To me, I believe him. He is on trial to you. If you believe him and if you judge him faithful to his word.
Vous êtes ici. Je crois qu'il est au procès pour vous, pas pour moi. Vous le croyez. Il est ici au procès pour vous et vous le croyez.
Oh, sorry. Okay.
Vous le croyez et vous le jugez de cette façon. Fidèle à sa parole.
So let us turn to Hebrews 11. I'll read a couple of scriptures that we go into prayer. I'll leave all these
nous
things.
Nous allons prendre Hébreux 11 et nous allons lire quelques versets et nous allons entrer dans la prière. Je peux
but,
pas lire
but when
tout
we
ça.
Say somebody's faithful, hope the young ones, you know what it means.
Mais quand nous disons que quelqu'un est fidèle, je pense que le jeune comprenne cela.
It means that the fellow is full of faith.
Ça veut dire
faithful. You know when you divide it.
Que la personne est pleine de foi.
That means he's very firm in adherence to his promises.
Donc il est tellement ferme aux promesses de Dieu.
It's not like me that when I say I will come at 7, maybe I'll come at 7:30. If somebody is faithful, 7 on the dot, he's there.
Ce n'est pas comme moi quand je vous dis que je viendrai à 7 heures, je ne viendrai pas à 7 heures. Mais quand quelqu'un est fidèle, quand il vous dit 7 heures, c'est 7 heures à sa
porte. I'm here to tell you the only faithful being is our Lord Jesus Christ.
Je suis ici tout simplement pour vous dire que le seul être fidèle, c'est notre Seigneur Jésus.
Because I am mortal, I might try, but I will fail.
Parce que je suis mortel, je peux tenter, mais je veux faillir.
But the promises of the living God have been tested and tried, and it has never failed.
Mais les promesses de Dieu vivant ont été testées et n'ont jamais failli.
So let's go to Hebrews 11, 6. I'll read 6, then I'll jump. I can't read all. I'll just read 6, then I'll read 8 to 12. Then we'll go to some few things that we could prepare. But without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him.
Le verset 6, Hébreux 11. Or, sans la foi, il est impossible de lui être agréable, car il faut que celui qui s'approche de Dieu croie que Dieu existe et qu'il est le rémunérateur de ceux qui le cherchent.
So what he's trying to tell us that for you to have something from God, you ought to judge him faithful that because he has promised, he will never fail.
Ça veut dire que non, pour que vous ayez la foi en Dieu, vous devez le juger qu'il est fidèle à sa parole.
I'll just jump to 11.
Je vais juste sauter au verset 11.
Because I want us to pray. Through faith also, Sarah herself received strength to conceive. And was delivered of a child when she was past age, because she judged him faithful who had promised.
C'est par la foi que Sarah elle-même, malgré son âge avancé, fut rendue capable d'avoir une postérité parce qu'elle crut à la fidélité de celui qui avait fait la promesse.
And that's where I want. That's what I took my text for. She judged him faithful who he was promised.
C'est là où j'ai pris mon inspiration qu'il a jugé fidèle celui qui avait promis.
When Elohim visited Abraham in Genesis 18.
Quand Elohim a visité Abraham dans Genèse 18.
And they discerned Sarah and they told him that Sarah would give birth. Sarah Sarah initially doubted it.
Et on a discerné Sarah et on lui a dit que Sarah allait enfanter. Sarah a premièrement douté cela.
But when Elohim in the form of man descended the heart of Sarah, and Sarah knew that hey, who is in our presence is not just a mere man, but it's God in flesh. He knew that it will come to pass.
Alors Sarah qui avait douté cela, mais quand Elohim dans la forme humaine avait discerné ce qui était dans le cœur de Sarah, alors elle s'est rendue compte que c'est lui qui était devant nous n'était pas seulement un simple homme, c'était le Dieu qui avait promis et il était fidèle.
Hope you caught a revelation of what
j'espère
I said.
Que vous aviez saisi la révélation ici.
Malachi 4 has come, that's the messenger to us. He veiled God to bring the message.
Malachi 4 est venu, ça c'est notre messager, et notre messager il a enveloppé Dieu pour nous.
If you would dissolve your doubt and see behind that veil that God is in our midst, you will have what you have need of.
Si vous dissolvez ce doute et voyez que c'est lui qui est derrière ce voile, c'est Dieu au milieu de nous, alors vous allez.
So there are so many people in the Bible that judge God faithful. I won't have
alors,
time to go through.
Alors il y a beaucoup de gens dans la Bible qui ont jugé Dieu fidèle.
Notable among them is Abraham himself and Sarah, we read of the Shunammite woman.
Il y a le plus populaire c'est Abraham, Sarah et la femme Shunammite.
Even in death she cried out it is well.
Même quand elle avait des dettes dans la mort elle a crié que non tout était
because
bon.
She knew that once God has given to him the son and the son died, or whatever it is, out of stroke, sunstroke, or whatever it is. Once he gets to the prophets whose word brought that life, that son can come back to life.
Alors, elle avait cru que c'est l'enfant qui lui était donné, bien qu'il était mort. Mais dès qu'elle allait rencontrer le prophète, cet enfant allait revivre.
Because she judged the words of the prophet, which was the words of God faithful.
Parce qu'elle a jugé le parole du prophète qui était le parole de Dieu.
The widow, the widow woman in 1 Kings 17, too the same.
La veuve dans 1 roi 17, la même chose.
She just had a cruse of oil and a little flour.
Elle avait juste une cruche d'huile et un peu de farine.
Elijah came, he said, go and fetch me water. He says, okay, this man, let me share. After all, we die.
Alors, Élie est venu, il a dit, va, trouve-moi de l'eau. Elle a dit, bon, nous
then
avons
Elijah
juste partagé.
Then Elijah said, well, you are coming, bake me. He said, hey, this prophet.
Alors, il dit, maintenant tu viens, fais-moi un gâteau. Elle a dit, oh, c'est prophète.
But once he discerned that the man of God was speaking the words of God, and the man of God promised him that if you do it, you will never lack in the midst of this drought. She judged it faithful, and brethren, she didn't lack.
Mais une fois qu'elle a discerné que les paroles du prophète, c'est lui qui lui avait promis que une fois que tu le faisais, tu ne vas jamais manquer dans cette sécheresse. Elle a jugé ces paroles comme fidèle.
The Hebrew boys. I love those boys. I wish I had faith like those Hebrew boys.
Alors, les enfants hébreux, je les aime. J'aurais voulu avoir leur foi.
Daniel 3 said, we know that our God can deliver us. But even if...
Daniel a dit, nous savons que notre Dieu peut nous délivrer, mais même si...
So God could have done A, B, and C. God would have prevented this. God could have done this. But even if he doesn't do it or he didn't do it, we'll still judge him to be faithful.
Alors, Dieu pouvait faire A ou B ou C ou n'importe quoi. Mais même s'il ne le faisait pas, nous allons continuer à le juger comme fidèle.
And like we read, God will always make a way of escape for those that judge him faithful.
Alors, comme nous venons juste de voir, Dieu va toujours frayer une issue de sortie pour ceux qui ont la foi.
Do we all get what I'm trying to
est-ce
say?
Est-ce que nous comprenons tout ce que c'est que je
so the last
dire.
One I will refer to and read a quote is, you know that night in Egypt on the 10th plague.
Vous savez, le dernier cas que je vais traiter ou je vais lire dans la Bible et une citation, c'était cette nuit-là en Égypte.
God gave Abraham a promise in Genesis 15 that his land would sojourn in a strange land for 400 years.
Dieu avait donné la promesse à Abraham que sa postérité allait être dans une terre étrangère pendant 400 ans.
And he said, I will deliver them with my mighty hand of deliverance.
Et il lui avait dit que moi, je vais les délivrer avec ma main puissante.
And because he's a faithful God, he kept to his word.
Mais comme il est un Dieu fidèle, il a gardé sa parole.
And Moses came on the scene after so many plagues, the ninth, the tenth one. God told Moses, tell the children of Israel, apply the dog to the lintel of your household, because the dead angel is passing through tonight, and those that don't do so will have their first son dead.
Alors Moïse était venu après tout le plaie à la dixième plaie, et Dieu lui a dit, dis à mon peuple qu'ils doivent appliquer le sang au linteau de leur maison, parce que ceux qui ne le feront pas, leur fils aîné mourra.
And Brother Branham said something about that shook me, that has made me tread cautiously of late.
Frère Branham a dit quelque chose qui m'a vraiment secoué, qui fait que je puisse être très prudent ces derniers temps.
Let me read that.
J'ai
Brother Branham
ça.
Said, then the Israelites once settled there, what if they get to study? Well, I'm not worthy. What else do I have to do? You don't have to do nothing. The only thing is to come under the shed blood.
Alors, si les enfants d'Israël, ceux qui étaient là, disaient par exemple en train d'étudier, « Oh non, je ne suis pas digne, qu'est-ce que je peux faire ?» Non, tu ne dois rien faire. Tout ce que tu dois faire, c'est juste de venir sous le sang qui a été versé.
That settles it.
Et ça résout le problème.
Once under the blood, you are safe.
Une fois en dessous du sang, tu es en sécurité.
What if the dead angel with his sword in his hand sweeping to the land, you didn't have to wonder and to be scared? And to be scared was an insult to Jehovah.
Alors, si vous dites par exemple, si vous êtes sous le sang, ou quand serait-il si l'ange de la mort venait avec son épée, vous n'avez pas à vous demander parce que vous étiez en dessous du sang. Et c'est poser des questions, c'était une insulte à Jehovah.
Did you get that?
Est-ce que vous avez saisi
ça? That once God has promised in his word, and you come to knowledge of it and you begin to doubt, it's an insult to God.
Quand vous arrivez au point vous doutez aux promesses de Dieu, ça c'est une insulte à Dieu.
That's a big statement.
Ça c'est une déclaration très grande.
When you go home, think about it.
Quand vous allez à la maison, pensez-y.
The moment you are doubting God's word in your life, in my life, you are insulting Jehovah God.
Le moment où vous commencez à douter à sa parole dans ma vie, dans votre vie, vous êtes en train d'insulter
And
Jehovah.
And tonight, that's where we're going to start with the Lord forgive us.
Alors, ce soir, c'est ce que nous allons commencer avec demander pardon.
I am inclusive. You are inclusive. Forgive us for such treacherous acts.
Je suis inclus. Vous êtes aussi inclus. Pardonne-nous de cet acte ignoble.
Let me continue to read.
Je vais continuer.
Brother Branham said, if a man once under the blood feels afraid that God won't keep his word, it's an insult to him. Say, Jehovah, perhaps this is your word, but I don't know whether it's right or not.
Alors, si un homme qui est en dessous de sang commence à être peur, à avoir peur que Dieu, je ne sais pas si tu vas garder ta parole. Alors, ça, c'est une insulte à lui. C'est une que non, Jehovah. Peut-être ta parole, mais je ne sais pas. Non, ça, ce n'est pas correct.
Brother Branham said, oh, shame on you.
Frère Branham dit, honte à vous.
Why, once under the blood, he said, I am the Lord that healeth thee. I believe it, that's all. Don't insult him.
Alors, une fois de plus, sous le sang, il a dit, je suis le Seigneur qui guérit toute la maladie. Alors, croyez cela, ne l'injuriez pas.
Did we hear that?
Est-ce que nous avions entendu
Tonight
cela?
We are it's a serious thing, no?
C'est une chose très sérieuse.
If you've ever doubted the word of God, including me, we are going the Lord pardon us and help our unbelief.
Si nous avions jamais douté la parole de Dieu, inclus-moi, nous allons
demander
de nous pardonner.
And tonight, henceforth, whatever need we put before you, we will judge you faithful.
Alors Dieu, ce soir, toute parole, toute requête que nous allons déposer devant toi, nous allons te juger fidèle.
He said, he that cometh unto me, I will nowise cast him out. I believe it. Once coming under the blood, take his word for anything he says.
Il a dit, celui qui viendra à moi, je ne veux pas le chasser. Alors, croyez cela. Une fois que vous venez sous le sang, prenez sa parole.
And
c'est ce qu'il a dit.
And every believer, here it is, get it. Every man or woman that has once been brought under the blood of Christ, all fear and condemnation is gone.
Alors, tout croyant, tout celui, vous saisissez cela. Tout homme ou toute femme qui, une fois sous le sang, toute crainte, toute condamnation est partie.
Then he will believe every word that God writes in the Bible to be truth.
Alors, il va croire toute parole qu'il a dite dans la Bible est vraie.
He will not say this is not inspired or that's not inspired, but he will believe every word of it.
Il ne va pas dire que ceci est inspiré ou cela n'est pas inspiré. Il va croire toute la parole.
Amen.
Amen.
Come to the fountain filled with blood.
Venez à la fontaine remplie du sang.
John from Emmanuel's views. Oh, what a wonderful Savior we have. What a plan of redemption God has allotted out for us, laid out the carpet for us to come home on notice.
Tiré de veine d'Emmanuel, oh quel sauveur merveilleux que nous avons, quel plan de rédemption de Jéhovah, lui seul qu'il a pourvu pour nous.
Oh, sorry.
Il a mis un venez à la maison et remarquez cela.
How many people will go to God before we lay our knees that God forgive us for?
Combien de gens iront chez Dieu et dire avant que nous lui amenons nos requêtes
pour Dieu? I want to end with this story.
Je vais terminer avec cette histoire.
Of two women that came in the prayer line that judged God faithful and what he did for them. It's a familiar story, but I'll read it out and we pray.
Deux femmes we're going to prayer. Qui étaient venues dans la ligne des prières et ils ont jugé Dieu fidèle. Et c'est une histoire familière, mais je vais la lire.
Here just recently, two women I was telling about here a few nights ago, cause I got a letter on it and they come to the meeting.
Voilà maintenant, il y a deux femmes qui étaient venues ici et je vais en parler parce que j'ai reçu la lettre qui était venue ici dans la réunion.
One woman was said in the meeting when she came by with a stomach trouble.
Et une est venue avec un problème d'estomac.
Now watch it, it will speak the name of the Lord.
Maintenant, observez, ça va parler le nom du Seigneur.
Brother Bram is talking about the discernment. It will tell you what it is, what's going to happen.
Ça va vous dire exactement ce qu'il en est, ce qui va arriver.
See, if it doesn't, then I don't know. I can only say what it says.
Si ça ne va pas le faire, je ne sais pas, mais je vais tout simplement vous dire ce qu'il dit.
I can't make it, that's God.
Je ne peux pas manufacturer ça, c'est Dieu.
So it told her she was going to get well off her stomach trouble.
Alors, ça lui avait dit qu'elle allait être guérie de son problème d'estomac.
And it told another woman with a lump on her throat that in the name of the Lord it was going to leave her.
Alors, ça dit à l'autre femme qui avait quelque chose sur sa gorge que ça allait partir d'elle.
So she, I told her to go home, she said, and eat what she wanted to.
Alors, je lui ai dit, va à la maison et mange tout ce que tu veux manger.
Do we get the picture? Two people came in the prayer line. One with a stomach trouble, one with a lump. And Brother Brown told the one with a stomach trouble is going to leave her. Are we getting it, please?
Est-ce que nous saisissons cela?
So she said, I told her to go home, she said, and eat what she wanted.
Je lui ai dit d'aller à la maison et de manger tout ce qu'elle voulait.
Well, she tried. Why my? She liked to die.
Alors, elle a tenté. Oh mon Dieu, elle allait mourir.
She will try to eat and she will vomit and everything.
Elle va tenter de manger, elle va vomir tout.
Well, weeks passed, 3 or 4 weeks.
Alors, des semaines sont passées, 3 ou 4 semaines.
And one morning, the family had gone to work. Children gone to school and she was hungry.
Alors, un matin, les enfants étaient partis à l'école et tout le monde était parti au travail et elle avait faim.
And she said she felt like something cool go through her.
Et elle a senti comme si quelque chose pouvait passer.
Brethren, experience with God is real.
Frère, une expérience avec Dieu, elle est réelle.
She would try and take a little bite of toast and it didn't come up. Hallelujah.
Alors, elle va essayer de manger un petit morceau de pain et ça ne ressortait pas.
She taking some oats and it didn't.
Et il a mangé quelques... céréales, c'était plus ressorti.
And she drank a cup of coffee. Oh man, she was just doing fine. Hallelujah.
Elle a bu quelques cafés. Elle était en bon état et ça ne sortait pas.
So she thought she would run through and tell her neighbor down the street what had happened.
Alors elle a pensé que non, elle devait courir et aller dire à son voisin ce qui lui était arrivé.
So she's still testifying of Eli. Nobody knew what she couldn't eat. She just knew it herself.
Alors, elle témoignait à propos de sa guérison. Personne ne savait qu'elle ne pouvait pas manger. Elle le savait.
And she was trying her best, but she said she'll get it. So he said, if God is able to tell me by inspiration what I was and what and how I got sick and what caused me to be sick and told me I was going to be well, I believe it. Hallelujah.
Elle a tout simplement essayé. Elle s'est dit, si Dieu peut me dire par inspiration ce que j'étais et ce que je suis, si Dieu peut tout simplement me dire ce qui a causé ma maladie et comment je suis devenu malade, moi je vais le croire.
That's the way. That's why she had an idea. She ran down the street to tell her friend about it. Few doors down the street.
Alors c'était correct. C'était de cette façon qu'elle a couru pour dire à son voisin qu'elle avait de ce qui lui était arrivé.
And down the street she went, and in the house she was going to tell her about. She heard somebody screaming, top of her voice. The woman's in the middle of the floor. The growth had left her throat that morning. Hallelujah!
Alors, elle était juste prête à lui dire ce qui est arrivé. Elle a entendu quelqu'un qui était en train de crier que cette dame était par terre. Celle qui avait quelque chose sur sa gorge était partie depuis ce matin-là.
And she was screaming to the top of her voice.
Et elle était en train de crier fort.
What had happened?
Qu'est-ce qui est arrivé?
The same angel of God who blessed those things and had word from God, she who spoke through lips and said what was and told them it was going to be, passed through the neighborhood that morning, hunting those people he had pronounced that blessing.
Alors, qu'est-ce qui est arrivé? Le même ange de Dieu qui avait placé ces choses, qui avait prononcé ces paroles à travers les lèvres, qu'est-ce qui est arrivé? Il est passé dans ses voisinages ce matin en train de chercher ces gens chez qui il avait promis ses bénédictions.
And that settled it.
Et ça règle cela.
See, they can't just get to you just exactly when you want them to be. Amen.
Ça ne peut pas tout simplement vous arriver juste au moment où vous voulez que ça vous arrive.
Hope you got the import of that story.
J'espère que vous aviez compris l'histoire de cette histoire.
That if you judge him faithful and hold on, brethren, one of these mornings, one of these afternoons, one of these evenings, the angel of God, the angel of mercy, will pass by your neighborhood.
Et bien aimé, si vous le jugez fidèle, qu'un jour, un de ces quatre matins, l'ange de Dieu va passer dans votre quartier.
And God will make a way. Hallelujah.
Dieu va créer un chemin.
Are we going to judge him tonight, faithful?
Est-ce que nous allons le juger ce soir, fidèle?
Are we going to judge him faithful, brethren?
Est-ce que nous allons le juger ce soir, fidèle, bien-aimé?
Faithful is he who has promised, and great is his faithfulness.
Fidèle est celui qui a promis, et grand est sa fidélité.
I like that scripture, Lamentations 3:21-25. It says, it's of the Lord's mercies we are not consumed. Great is thy faithfulness.
J'aime ce passage dans Lamentations 13:25 que si nous ne sommes pas consumés par ta miséricorde, c'est par ta grâce et ta gloire est suffisante.
So we're going to pray. Pray like it is your last. Let me even loosen my tie.
Priez comme si c'était votre dernière prière. Je vais juste dénouer.
And I don't want to see anybody sleeping, though, because I don't want you to hinder our blessings.
Je n'aimerais pas voir des gens dormir.
If you know you are going to sleep, stand.
Si vous savez que vous allez dormir, levez-vous.
Because if you're going to sleep, we are praying and we mean business. Amen.
Si tu sais que tu vas dormir, nous sommes en
train de prier. Actually, let us all of us rise.
Alors, s'il vous plaît, tenons-nous
tous debout. So we don't sleep, young and old.
Jeune et vieux.
Let us get ready to pray. Amen.
As we sing that song. Pour prier, comme nous allons chanter la chanson.
He has promised he will never fail. I will adore him. I will adore him. Let's all sing it, brethren.
Hallelujah, why?
thanking God for how far He has brought us.
Pour que le temps qu'il nous a amené ici.
Many other times we've doubted Him, but yet still He has spared us to live.
D'autres fois nous l'avions douté, mais il nous a toujours protégé.
Therefore, if nothing for nothing, He has given you life tonight, regardless, and you ought to be thankful unto Him.
Si pour rien il vous a donné la vie, qu'importe comment, votre vie doit le remercier.
Therefore, lift up your hands and raise up your voice and thank Him for all that He has done for you.
Levez vos mains et remerciez-le pour tout ce qu'il a fait pour vous.
Regardless of the situation, brethren, He has been good.
Qu'importe la situation. Bien-aimé, il a toujours été
it
bon.
Could have been worse, but His grace and His mercy has brought us thus far.
Ça pouvait être pire, mais sa grâce et sa miséricorde
and because
nous
His grace, we have promised He will make a way of escape for us.
Mais parce qu'il est fidèle, il a promis qu'il va créer une voie pour nous.
Therefore, let us pray and thank the Lord.
Alors,
Heavenly Father, tonight we want
Seigneur.
To say thank you. We bless you. We adore you. We worship you for who you are. Great things you've done, dear Lord, and greater things we believe you're gonna do. Had it not been your love, your care, your sustenance, where will it be? Dear Lord Jesus, this hour we're in your presence, not by privilege of who we are, dear Lord, in ourselves, but it's your riches that Christ has spent that has been made known unto us. And we want to say thank you. We bless you. We adore you. We want to thank you for salvation. So rich and so rich, so go free, dear Lord, that you've bestowed to us, O God, through Calvary. We thank you, dear Lord, for the message of the hour, hidden from the prudent and the wise, but you've revealed it unto us. Babes such as will learn, O God, we thank you for our jobs. We thank you for our families. We thank you, dear Lord, going out, our coming in. We thank you for shelter. We thank you for your provision in everything. Just like David said, we will bless you at all times, and your praise shall continually be in our mouth. For great things you've done, dear Lord, and greater things we believe you're going to do. We exalt your name on high tonight, and we want to say thank you from the depths of our heart, dear Lord, for you reign and forever. Thy works are marvelous in thy sight. Who can be compared unto you among the gods? There is none, dear Lord. Therefore, we bow down and kneel before thee, dear Lord, and worship thee in the splendor of your love and in the beauty of your holiness. For thou alone art worthy, you are worthy to be praised. And therefore we join hands with the host of angels, crying, all glory, all power, honor be unto your holy name. For you are worthy. Worthy is the Lamb that was slain before the foundation of the world for us, O God. And we exalt your name on high. We thank you and we bless you for who you are. To you be all the glory. Let us continue to pray. Ask God to forgive us of our transgressions, our doubt, our fear. That tonight, as we go into His presence, we want to exhibit faith. We want to cast out fear and unbelief. Let us pray. Oh, Heavenly Father, we come, Lord Jesus, through the blood tonight, O God. Oh, Heavenly Father, who can stand before thy presence, dear Lord, blameless except through the blood. We therefore pray, coming, Lord Jesus, with humility, dear Lord, humbleness of heart to God, sincerity in the provider way, crying out unto you, Father, 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 please forgive us of our iniquities, forgive us of our transgressions, forgive us of our doubt towards your promises, O God. I pray, Heavenly Father, I'm the most needy. Forgive me, dear Lord, if I've doubted you in any way, minor, major, and I pray, help thou my unbelief henceforth, O God, to hold on to your unchanging word, to hold on to your promises in the good, in the bad, in the beautiful. Lord Jesus, charge you faithful in all things. Not only me, we bring the assembly, Lord, those down here, dear Lord, those in their various abodes. We pray, Lord, come in, Lord, as a unit, O God, under the blood tonight, Heavenly Father, that Jesus be merciful unto us. Search our hearts, O God, from the crown of our heads to the sole of our feet. If there be anything in our lives so contrary to thy word, Lord Jesus, in our ways of action, in our speech, in our sight, to God, down in our heart, to God, search us tonight, to God, and cleanse and purify us, refine us fire. And we pray, we rededicate in our lives, that may the faith of God move in us, making us true believers, that we will hold on to your word, that we would, dear Lord, proclaim thy blessings and thy promises are true. And because you are faithful, you will bring it to pass. Tonight, deal with us not according to the multitude of our iniquities, O God, but let your grace and your mercy locate us, O God. Your riches are Christ's expense, O God. Be our portion tonight is our humble prayer. And as we come, may we leave, not leave your presence with curses, O God, but bless beyond measure, dear Lord, looking unto thee, the author and the finisher of our faith, that he who by the blast of your nostrils the rest he parted into two, you are mighty God, and you will never fail. For heaven and earth will pass away, but your words are forever sure. We thank you and we bless you that you are faithful God, and you will change and not. We thank you and we bless you. Brethren, let us continue to pray. Let us not sleep. Tonight, our first prayer is to pray for the church, for the needs in the church. Many other needs. We are walking through a dark time this hour. Let us pray that God Himself will descend and be gracious unto us. Yes, that the gates of heaven will fight against us, but thanks be unto His name that they will not prevail. Let us commit the church, let us commit the young ones, the old ones, that Christ will be found in our lives. That's the most important thing. That all of us will be truly filled with the Holy Ghost. That all of us will have that token applied. Like Grandpapa was saying some months ago, some days, some weeks ago, that the most important thing is the token, brethren, the Holy Ghost. For what shall we profit a man if he gains the whole world and loses his soul? Let us pray for the church, one another, pray for families that you know, as many as you can, that God will be merciful for us, both the young ones and the old ones. Let us pray. Oh, Heavenly Father, we come before your throne of grace, Lord Jesus, tonight. I pray and feel, Lord Jesus, this Lord assembly into your care. Oh, Lord, the assurance we have in our hearts that because you planted it, dear Lord, you will water it, dear Lord, and it will come to fruition. I pray, dear Lord, at a critical hour, but just like David said, yeah, though we walk through the valley of the shadow of death, we will fear no evil, for thou with us, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort us. Yes, you may strike us at some point in time, but we will hold on, for we know you are faithful, Father. I therefore pray from the leadership, dear Lord, down to the young ones, oh God. I pray, Lord, the most important thing is for us not to be sympathizers, but Lord Jesus, true believers of the word, and you, Jesus, baptizing us with the Holy Ghost and fire. I therefore pray, dear Lord, any element of Lord Jesus playing dilly-dally, any element of lukewarmness, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we cast those demons out of our lives, and we pray, dear Lord, come and fill us, come and shine through us, oh God. I pray, come in this church, this local assembly, let it be a shining example in the world that you are faithful, Father, that you sorrow in joy. We will still hold on to your word. I pray, Lord, divine understanding, divine unity, dear Lord. Except you build a builder's builder in vain. Except you watch, Heavenly Father, the watchman watches in vain. Therefore, we cannot do it on our own. Therefore, we invite you, dear Lord, that take charge, take dominion, oh God. Provide, Lord, your own path for us. Let the word of God be a lamp unto our feet, that pure undefiled word, a light unto our path, oh God. Divine revelation of the word in our souls, oh God. Now, truly, dear Lord, we'll be more than conquerors, as your word has predicted. I pray, Lord, bless this church. I pray, dear Lord, establish them, dear Lord. Enlarge your territory, dear Lord. May the gates of hell never prevail against them because you said so. I therefore pray, commit it all to your care. From the ministers, the deacons, dear Lord, the trustees, dear Lord Jesus, the janitors, dear Lord, the young ones, the Sunday school teachers, I pray, bless us all. May we all be diligent in our service of God unto thee. Grant us the strength. Grant us the capability. Protect your children from harm's way. I pray, may this church be built on the solid rock of Jesus Christ, the true revelation of thy word. I pray, bless your people, Heavenly Father. Go before your children, just like the angel of the Lord Jesus led the children of Israel by the hand of Moses. So have we believed your prophet of God, and may the angel of the Lord encamp around us as we fear, Lord, bring to you, Lord Jesus, the reverence needed. And I pray, lead your people. That's our desire and that's our goal. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we thank you and we bless you. Let us pray, committing the leadership of the church, most especially, that God will grant them wisdom to treat all matters right.
Prions pour ceux qui conduisent l'église, pour que Dieu leur donne la sagesse pour pouvoir traiter tout sujet.
May family matters, whatever it is, that God will give each and every leader in the part of the leadership of the church wisdom to handle them.
Que ce soit des problèmes familiaux, que Dieu donne la la sagesse à ceux qui conduisent de pouvoir
traiter cela. That peace will dwell among the children of the living God. Let us pray.
La paix soit parmi les enfants de Dieu.
Heavenly Father, dear Lord Jesus, oh God, we'll come before your throne of grace, dear Lord. What good will it be, dear Lord Jesus, to go about, Lord, without divine wisdom, without divine understanding, dear Lord? I pray, dear Lord, to settle your children's, Lord Jesus, matters according to the Holy Ghost. You told Lord Jesus, Moses, Lord, by the father-in-law's, Lord Jesus, advice, that he should set up elders, oh God, who will deal with minor matters, oh God, and him dealing with Lord Jesus, the major matters. So have you said in your church, a leadership, Lord, individual ministers, deacons, trustees. I pray, dear Lord, grant them that divine wisdom, that principal wisdom you gave unto soldiers, O God. I pray may we not judge according to our intellect, but divine, Lord Jesus, leadership of the Holy Ghost, providing, Lord Jesus, direction and peace, Lord. I pray, Lord, once more, commit families, loved ones, far and near. If the devil is wanting to try and cry, commit, Lord Jesus, your children to be divided, Lord. Division here and there. We break, bind, and set it loose, Lord. It is the work of the evil one to divide families, Lord, to divide the children of the living God. I therefore pray, arise, O God, and let the enemy be scattered in the wall of Jericho, of partition, division, that they want to be built among your children. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we sound for the trumpet of liberty, that you will pull down the strongholds of the enemy, Heavenly Father, and let peace be settled. Let your children dwell in love. Let your children dwell in unity. Abide in Lord Jesus in the comfort of thy word, and press it on as a unit, as a portion of the bride, towards the goal of the mark of the high calling. We need you, dear Lord, without you we fail. Come and with us abide. Help our feeble hands and our feeble legs. It's our humble prayer in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. And we pray with thanksgiving. Let us continue to pray for pregnant sisters, that God will keep them, as many as you know. And remember those that are looking for children too. Our God is still faithful. He still grants Sarah conceived by judging God faithful. He receives strength to conceive, and he can still do it. Let us pray for all pregnant sisters and those seeking the fruit of the womb. Pray, brothers and sisters, pray. Don't be lazy. Lay your knees before the Lord. Jesus Christ, we come before your throne of grace tonight, dear Lord. You has promised us that a barren shall not be found in thy household, that children are the heritage of Lord Jesus, your sons and daughters. I therefore pray, dear Lord, come in all loved ones, you know them all by names. Heavenly Father, even as Sarah judge you faithful to receive strength to conceive, I pray, dear Lord, lifting my hands unto you, please be merciful unto us as we judge you faithful tonight, to God, north and south, east and west. I pray, dear Lord, if you were the Virgin Mary was able to conceive, and Lord Jesus, to God, Zachariah, Elizabeth, Lord, Sarah, and Lord Jesus, Abraham were able to conceive in their old age. Lord, therefore, we have no excuse to believe thee. You've done it before, and you can do it again. And therefore, we pray, dear Lord, help our unbelief. But we hold on, reach out, and touch the hem of your garment tonight, and judge you faithful. Not look to the circumstance, not look to doctor's report, but look unto thee, who cried on Calvary, that is finished. And we know you will make a way where the cement will be no way. We thank you in advance for making a way. To God be all the glory. We adore you, Heavenly Father. Let us pray for all the frontliners in this pandemic.
Prions pour ceux qui sont en première ligne durant ces pandémies.
By the grace of God, we've not had any loved one with this COVID or whatever it is. And let us thank God and continue to commit ourselves into his care, that he will keep us and protect us.
Prions aussi, nous avons des bien-aimés qui sont en première ligne. Prions que Dieu puisse nous garder contre ce COVID.
Remember all frontliners, the doctors, the nurses. Brethren, the devil is roaring like a lion seeking to devour. Therefore, pray and once more commit yourself into God to hide you under the blood. Let us pray.
Rappelez-vous de docteurs, des infirmiers. Le diable est en train de s'émouvoir comme un lion cherchant qui ils peuvent dévorer. Prions.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, Lord Jesus, we come before your throne of grace. Lord God, just like you did for the children of Israel in Goshen. Now, Heavenly Father, while the plague was going, you gave them a token that hid them from the snare of the fowler. So do we come to you, Lord, we thank you. In the midst of all this pandemic, these demons flying about, you've kept your children, you've protected. We want to say thank you. We're going to commit ourselves into your care. We have nowhere else to go to but thee and thee alone. And therefore, pray, dear Lord, commit all and sundry, especially frontliners, doctors, nurses, Lord Jesus, oh God, medtechs and whatever it is. Now hide your people under the blood, shelter them from the snare of the evil one. I pray, dear Lord, may they dwell in the secret place of the Most High God all the days of our lives. May your shining light abide around them, dear Lord, that the enemy, Lord Jesus, cannot attack their health. I pray, dear Lord, may they prosper in good health, all of us inclusive, O God. Keep and continue to sustain us, O God. I pray, dear Lord, may your presence always abide with us, for you promised us, O God, in your presence there's fullness of joy, and that joy comes from both spiritual health and physical health. And therefore pray may our joys be made full, even as, Lord, we go through this pandemic, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Let us pray, commit families. We've already prayed for that God will continue to keep us united. Let's commit all the sick and afflicted, brethren, as many as you know.
Remettons ceux qui sont malades et ceux qui sont affligés.
He is still a healer. Hallelujah.
Il est toujours un guérisseur. Hallelujah.
And he has already done it. And all we need to do is to hold on to his changing hands.
C'est juste de tenir sa main immuable.
And a prayer request from my sister says we should pray that the church will stay together and also for protection this COVID. So let us pray.
Il y a aussi une prière qui vient d'une sœur qui demande que nous puissions rester ensemble, que l'église reste ensemble et que nous soyons aussi protégés contre ce COVID.
Let us pray. Brother, I want to hear you pray. Lift up your voice and pray to God. It's a prayer answering God. If you are serious, he will meet you at the point of your need. The young ones, everybody, close your eyes and pray.
Fermez vos yeux et priez.
Heavenly Father, Lord, is there anything too hard for thee? You query Jeremiah and Abraham, Heavenly Father. When you were here on earth in flesh, your God that brought a multitude of sick and afflicted, and the Bible said you healed them all. You are still a faithful Father, dear Lord. No matter how long it is taking, Lord, we want to judge you faithful tonight. I pray, commit all the sick and the afflicted, known and unknown, hypertensive, diabetics, autistics, whatever it is, demons, oh God, are afflicting the flesh of your evil, of your sons and daughters. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, he rose from the dead. I pray, Heavenly Father, any foul demonic powers hiding in the bodies of your children, we rebuke them in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Arise, Heavenly Father, heal your children, dear Lord. You promise us you are the God that healeth all our infirmity. Oh, what a blessed assurance, and therefore we are holding on to it tonight. I pray, dear Lord Jesus, please be merciful unto us, and let the angel of mercy pass by. Lord, let it pass by, God, and touch your children and make them whole in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. I pray, dear Lord, grant your children the faith, dissolve doubt, dissolve fears, dissolve, Lord Jesus, anxiety. May we know that you are a faithful Father, that you've never failed, and you would do it. If Lazarus 4 days, Lord, in the grave was able to come back to life, how much more than living? You are still a faithful Father, and you still heal. You are still in the healing business. Therefore, let it be our portion according to your promised word for us, even as we believe tonight, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. One more from a sister here. It says, thank God with me for all that he has done. I just want to bring praises to his house for our trials, tribulations, joy, peace, mountains, valleys, and so many, too many things to mention. Shalom, please pray for more and more of God for all of us.
Il y a aussi une sœur qui a soumis sa requête ici. Elle dit que non, elle veut que nous remercions le Seigneur ensemble avec elle pour tout ce qu'elle a fait, tout ce qu'il a fait pour elle. Il y a beaucoup qu'elle ne puisse pas mentionner.
One more here says, please pray for my twin who was involved in a motor accident and has leg burned and wound got infected, not yet healed, as expected. Let us pray also for this.
Et il y a aussi une autre requête ici pour un frère jumeau ou une sœur jumelle d'un d'entre nous qui était dans un accident et dont la plaie est maintenant infectée et elle n'est pas encore guérie. Que nous puissions prier pour cette personne.
Let us pray, brethren.
Prions,
bien-aimés. Oh, Heavenly Father, Lord, we've been singing it, and this is the time to display that the God on the mountain is still God in the valley. I pray, dear Lord Jesus, identify with my sister. In all our trials, we want to say thank you. In all our tribulations, we want to say thank you. In all our lows, we want to say thank you. For Lord God, all things are working together for our good. I pray tonight, dear Lord, identify with his sister. For all of us, we want to give you glory and praise. And we pray, dear Lord, that give us strength for the days are dreary. Give us, Lord, your overcoming faith to weather the storm. I pray in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Just like you were in the boat where the disciples of God and the storms of life rose, you rose up and rebuked them, oh ye of little faith. Heavenly Father, help our unbelief, and may we call you on the scene in all our endeavors. And we know, just like you did them back then, and you cried out, peace be still, you will still do it again. And therefore pray, commit various storms. We cannot exhaust all the prayer requests. You know them all, known and unknown, spoken and unspoken. I pray, Heavenly Father, let peace be still in the lives of your children, that they will come back to your house giving you praise, honor, and adoration, and glorify your name for what you've done, for you've never failed. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we pray with thanksgiving. Amen. We want to pray. Lastly, we know the situation. We want to commit our dear sister, Sister Peace.
Nous voulons commettre notre sœur Peace.
Brethren, it's not an easy thing to the flesh.
Frère, ce n'est pas une chose facile pour la chair.
So we ought to bear her in prayer. No matter what we say, if God hasn't revealed it to her, it won't do any good, brethren.
Donc, nous devons l'apporter dans nos prières parce que qu'importe ce que nous disions, si Dieu ne
l'a time to bear her up in prayer.
C'est le moment de l'apporter en
so
prière.
So pray like it is you.
If
you had been in that situation, how do you expect people to pray for you?
Si vous étiez dans cette situation, comment allez-vous vouloir que les gens
prient? And don't let it end here. Every day, every minute, pray in prayer, brethren.
Chaque prière, chaque minute, chaque seconde, portez-la en prière.
The children,
les enfants,
the in-laws, all of them, and the church as a whole. Let us pray for one another.
La famille et l'église tout entière, prions les uns pour les autres.
So this hour we want to bring her in prayer.
Donc en ce moment nous voulons la porter en prière.
Let us all lift up our voice and pray.
Levons tous nos voix et prions.
Oh King of Glory, the I Am that I Am. Lord, we want to be like that Shunammite woman tonight. That even in death, Lord Jesus, we want to testify that it is well. But these words are easy to say with a mortal tongue. Lord Jesus, accept you reveal it in our souls. Lord, we'll continue to linger in pain, Heavenly Father. I pray tonight, commit our dear sister, Lord, and the family, the nuclear family, into your care, Heavenly Father. If the devil, dear Lord Jesus, want to stampede her progress in Christ with this Lord Jesus trial, I rebuke that evil one in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. I pray, dear Lord, may divine peace and comfort from on high be her portion. Accept you do it, no man can do it. I therefore pray, dear Lord Jesus, please, Heavenly Father, remember the labor of love of your servant who has gone to be with you, and remember her family, dear Lord, down here. Be with them, keep them, dear Lord. I pray, strengthen them, dear Lord. Provide for their needs, material, financial, physical, whatever it is, dear Lord. Supply their needs according to your riches and glory. I pray, dear Lord, encamp around them, Lord, with the fire of the Holy Ghost, and I pray, strengthen their faith more and more. May the devil be rooted out of God, for he be, Lord Jesus, just like Job, who came out more victorious. May your lady that you've chosen, dear Lord, in this last days to be a living billboard that you are still a faithful Father, come out victorious just like Job. Bless, keep and sustain her, dear Lord, and go before her in all her endeavors. Abide with her, Lord. May her mind be kept on thee, dear Lord, for he who has promised us, you will keep us in perfect peace, he whose mind is stayed on thee. I pray, bless them, keep them, protect them, all the Lord members of the church. Lord Jesus, abide with us, O God. Lord Jesus, please keep us in harmony. I pray, dear Lord, the devil won't like to sow seeds of discrepancy and discord, but we rebuke them in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. We pray the love of God be shed abroad our hearts, and may your grace and your mercy be sufficient for us in all our endeavors. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we pray with thanksgiving. We want to call Brother Joe K to come and sum up our prayers for us as we round up.
Joe K pour qu'il puisse venir nous congédier.
Faithful Father,
notre Père fidèle,
once again we approach your throne.
Une fois de plus, nous approchons ton trône.
Heavenly Father, many requests have been brought in front of your presence.
Père, beaucoup de requêtes ont été apportées dans ta présence.
It's because we believe that you still answer prayer.
C'est parce que nous croyons que toi tu continues à répondre aux prières.
Heavenly Father, if we had any doubt in our hearts,
Père, si nous avions des doutes dans nos cœurs,
we pray that may you give us the faith of old.
Père, nous prions que tu puisses nous donner cette voix ancienne.
Help us to be faithful, Lord.
Aide-nous à être fidèles, Père.
Lord, once again, you said in your word.
Père, une fois de plus, tu as dit dans ta parole.
If you were to come back, would you find faith among your people?
Si tu revenais, est-ce que tu vas trouver la foi dans ton peuple?
We pray that we may be those people that still have faith.
Père, nous prions que nous soyons ce peuple qui a toujours cette foi.
The desire of our heart is to be faithful to your word.
Le désir de notre cœur, c'est d'être fidèle à ta parole.
Whatever you have in store for us, Heavenly Father, we are willing to bear it.
Tout ce que tu as dans ton magasin pour nous, nous avions, nous sommes plus prêts pour le porter.
We're willing to go all the way through with you, Lord.
Nous sommes prêts à aller jusqu'au bout avec toi, Seigneur.
Heavenly Father, we do not know what tomorrow holds, but we know who holds tomorrow.
Père, nous ne savons pas ce que demain nous réserve, mais nous savons qui tient le lendemain.
You have never failed, Lord, and we believe that you will never fail.
Père, tu n'as jamais failli, et nous croyons que tu ne vas jamais faillir.
You've kept us thus far by your grace.
Père, tu nous as gardés jusqu'en ce moment par ta grâce.
And if we hold on to that very same grace, we will take us all the way through.
Parce que si nous continuons à tenir à cette même grâce, tu vas nous accompagner jusqu'à la fin.
Surely your people, some are looking for children, Heavenly Father.
Sûrement tes enfants, certains sont en train de chercher le boulot, les enfants, Père.
We believe that you told us.
Père, nous croyons que tu nous as dit que dans ta parole qu'il n'y aura jamais de stérile dans ta maison.
Once again, may you visit their house, Lord.
Père, une fois de plus, que tu puisses visiter leur maison.
Give them an abundance above what they're expected.
Père, donne-leur en abondance.
Those that are looking for financial help, Lord.
Ceux qui sont en train de chercher l'aide financière.
You're still the same Jehovah Jireh of the world.
Tu es le même Jéhovah Jireh, Seigneur.
May you heal all the sick, Heavenly Father.
Que tu puisses guérir tous les malades.
The desire of our heart, Heavenly Father.
Le désir de notre cœur.
Is to see this church united.
C'est de voir cette église unie.
We do not want to be influenced by the outside decisions.
Nous ne voulons pas être influencés par des décisions du dehors.
But we want to be influenced by your word, Heavenly
Mais
Father.
Nous voulons être influencés par ta parole.
Keep us united under your word.
Garde-nous unis sous ta parole.
May you bless all of our ministers, Heavenly Father.
Bénis tous nos ministres.
Help all of us to stay faithful to your word.
Aide-nous à rester fidèles à ta parole.
Help all of our trustees, Heavenly Father.
Garde tous nos trésoriers.
Help all of us to stay faithful to your word.
Et aide-nous tous à rester fidèles à ta parole.
Help all of our deacons, Heavenly Father.
Aide tous nos diacres.
Help all of us to stay faithful to your word.
Et aide-nous tous à rester fidèles à ta parole.
Help all of our lay members, Heavenly Father.
Père, aide tous nos membres.
That we may all stay faithful to your word.
Que nous puissions tous rester fidèles à ta parole.
We do not have enough words to express how thankful we are to know that you watch over us.
Nous n'avons pas assez de mots pour exprimer combien gracieux, combien reconnaissant nous sommes comme tu nous gardes.
But your word tells us before we even open our mouth, you already know what's in our heart.
Mais ta parole nous dit que avant même que nous ouvrions nos bouches, toi tu connais déjà ce que nous voulions dire.
Receive our honor and glory.
Reçois toute la gloire et honneur.
Bless your servant that you have used tonight.
Bénis ton serviteur que tu as utilisé ce soir.
Restore the strength that he has used to give your word.
Restore la force qu'il a utilisée pour donner ta parole.
May the word that was spoken tonight let it not just be vain word that came to our ears, Lord.
Que les paroles qui sont sorties ne soient pas juste des paroles vaines qui sont passées dans nos oreilles.
We want to see the fruit of your word.
Nous voulons voir le fruit de ta parole.
Above all, in the name that is above all name, the name of your Son.
Au-dessus de tout, dans le nom qui est au-dessus de tout le nom de ton Fils.
Our Lord Jesus Christ, we pray and say Amen.
Notre Seigneur Jésus Christ, nous avons prié, disons Amen.
Amen.
God bless you all.
Que Dieu vous bénisse tous.
Pray for Sunday service that God will meet us at the point of our need. Amen.
Nous prions pour le service de dimanche que Dieu nous rencontre à notre point de besoin.
I think we exceeded time a little bit. Forgive me.
Je pense que nous avions dépassé le temps un peu.
But I miss you. I was greeting you.
Donc je vous ai manqué. J'étais juste en train de.
So what song are you playing, please? Great is thy faithfulness. Okay, let's sing it as we dismiss.
Nous allons chanter.
Thy hands have provided.
Great is thy faithfulness. the believers say. Once again, we thank each one of you for joining us tonight. Those here with us and those an invisible audience, thank you all for joining us tonight. And by the grace of God, our next service will be on Sunday. Our certain time will be 9 a.m. The Sunday school will be 9:30. Please join us and keep the church in prayers. We'll still be having Brother James Aran. He'll be speaking with us on Sunday. God bless you. Brother James also came with his wife, Sister Grace. You're welcome in the name of the Lord. Amen. Let us rise up on our feet tonight as we sing that song. I think it's 47. I know in whom I believed, and I'm persuaded that he's able to keep that which I've committed into his hands. Amen.
Say.